Oh, Jesus. I feel better going down an ice hill than going up one. Because you don't have all your weight against you. You can kind of just slide if you really needed to. Let's see, we might have to do that. Because that is a solid sheet of ice right there, looks like. I'm trying to walk in somebody else's footprints. Oh boy. Oh my goodness. Holy crap, I'm sliding. Holy shit.
Resume is a heavyweight, yeah. Put it on my back, give me everything, yeah. I need everything, I need all of everything, yeah.
Wow. Check this out. This is a nice little trail though, man. I'm definitely curious to see the entirety of it without fearing for my life or the safety of my freaking, what, $5,000 vlogging setup here. Verka Falls, we're not going back that way. Oh, what do we got over here? Just a loop road. Huh. All right, I think I'm just gonna go back the way I came. If I get lost out here, just send help. And somebody go to my house and walk Hobie. There was a mighty icy hill on the way up, which means I'm gonna have to slide down that son of a bitch on the way down. I think I'm gonna have to surfboard it. You know what? I'm gonna let these people behind me go first and see how they maneuver, and I'm just gonna copycat them. Did you walk up this shit right here?
Yeah, we did. It was tough, I'm not gonna lie. It was definitely tough.
I'm gonna just copy whatever you're doing because I don't feel like dropping this camera setup. Yeah, I will walk to the right, man. Surf it. Okay. My man got it right there. Okay. My man's nice with it right there. Nothing to it but to do it. So let's get to it. All right. So if my weight is this way, I definitely want to hold my camera in my right hand so that if I fall backwards, I fall on my left arm and I can keep the camera up in the air. Yeah, we're surfing. We're surfing. I'm not even walking. We're just sliding. Oh. This guy is walking his dog and he's running. He has no clue what he's about to encounter.
I guess I should put my cleats on.
Man, be careful right there. It's solid. Oh, what a beast. Thank you, sir. You just made me feel like the biggest bitch on the planet. I appreciate that. He just ran right up that shit. He's like Jesus. I think Jesus just jogged past me. I think he had cleats on. Damn liar. He said, I guess I should have brought my cleats out. That means you had your cleats on. You just flew right up that damn hill. Just wish he wouldn't lie to me like that. It's a Puerto Rican singing bear. All right, I better get the hell out of here. I know. Believe me, I'm well aware. You guys are hoping I fall. I get it, it's YouTube. All right, back to the studio.
Think I'm playing chess, I see a king, I'm at his neck. I'm 3 steps ahead of every move, now that's a check. Yes, they wanna know my secret, it's because I never slept. All my nightmares of me at 40, life's a wreck. See my dad, he in debt, and my mom.
All right, we're home. Let's get into this quick, since we spent so much time hiking on solid ice. This is the Suray 3T51K. This is a mini tripod, and the reason why I chose this as my vlogging grip, honestly, it's because it's probably the most heavy-duty, small, compact vlogging grip out there.
I don't know the payload on this, but I know that it supports this entire setup that I'm working with right now. And it's a pretty hefty setup, and this thing handles it with no problem. And what I did here, I don't know if you guys could see, if you look right there, I ordered these adhesive little sponge strips, and I didn't even have to cut them. This is exactly how they come. It was like meant to be. I'll leave a link in the description. There's a link, one link down low to my entire Amazon store if you want to pick up any of the items that you see here. And if I need to put other links for certain items that might not be in my Amazon store, they'll be down below as well. But I just threw these on here, and I'll tell you the truth, they came with a whole pack of them for like, I don't know, under 10 bucks. I have no clue. And it really does make a difference. It really softens up that grip. Because this is metal, kind of, it could dig into your fingers if you're holding it for too long of a period of time. And if you have a heavier setup, then you're probably giving it a good squeeze. And when you add these little sponge strips on here, everything works perfect. So I really like this mini tripod right here. I'm a big fan of Suray. You could have the legs extend like this, or there's a little snap dial, and then they go all the way out, and you can get nice and flat and low down. There's a nice little adjustable handle that you could just pull out and readjust to get it out of your way without actually tightening or untightening your position on the ball head. This is a definite go, at least for me. Let's move on to the next one, ND filters. Now, I just gotta give props and credit where credit is due. Polar Pro and Peter McKinnon absolutely have the best ND filters that I've ever used in my life, and I got both of them, I got the set. Vanessa bought them for me for Christmas. Thank you very much, Vanessa. Love you. There's like no flaws with these ND filters. Honestly, I've been trying to figure out some kind of flaw with them, but there's not. They literally covered every ground that's annoying with ND filters. Number one, my favorite thing probably is this like heavy duty rubber. Let's see if we can get it in there. For the ND filter, and the ND filter just sits inside right there, and it sits perfectly and it protects it. And this isn't even the case. The ND filters come with two cases. You get, where is it? So they give you this nice little Velcro well-made case. This feels like it's waterproof or something. And then inside you get a nice cleaning cloth that attached to it. So now it's kind of eliminating two things with one. I love attention to detail. Damn, I'm getting finger smudges. Oh, smudged it all up. Glad I have this. Damn it. These are the first smudges I've ever gotten on these filters. I was trying to avoid it and I didn't pay attention. And now I'm a little annoyed. Look at that. Clean as a whistle. Super official. And then they also come with these. A lot of reflection there. Which these are the ones I tend to carry around. That other soft cases, it's very protective and it's very nice, it's very good quality, and I'll probably take this with me when I travel, but you can see it is a little bit of a size difference here, so I tend to bring this around. Plus this is going to secure your case even more. And then the beauty of it is, number one, you have a nice magnet there, then you have your rubber guard covering the ND filter. And the beauty of it is you don't even, besides my thumb oils before, you don't even have to touch the ND filter at all to apply and remove it from your camera. You just put it on with the cap, twist it, lock it in, and then you peel the cap right off. It comes off super easy, but when you put it back on, it locks on. So even if your ND filter is on there super tight, just right off, no problem. And then when you're not filming, if you're out and about, maybe you gotta put your camera down for a little while, take a little lunch break, you gotta go for a drive somewhere, you put your camera on your passenger seat or something, you just pop this right back over, and now you don't have to worry about things brushing up against the front of your ND filter and scratching it all up and ruining it. And the other great thing is, you don't get that X. You never get the X, no matter what. I've tried to get it, you don't get it. By the way, none of this is being sponsored. I was not sent any of this for free. I paid for every single thing on this setup except for the microphone, but it just happens to be the best damn microphone I've ever used also. Which brings me to the microphone now. The Rode VideoMic NTG. Some of you guys may have seen a couple videos that I've done on it. I love this microphone. It's the best shotgun mic I've ever used. It doubles as a USB-C mic, so you can go from having it on top of your camera, you get home, let's say you wanna do some voiceovers in a studio and a computer, you just plug it right into the computer and it works perfect. It's so easy to set up. There's no like long process to work around to set this thing up. It's literally plug and play on both devices, your computer computer and your camera, not to mention the options on it. Now, this requires a whole new video, so if you do want to see what this mic is capable of and all the features, I will leave links at the end of the video right on the splash screen at the end. You just click it and go to the next video and check it out. This mic is phenomenal. I am super in love with it, and it has replaced the Rode Video Mic Pro Plus, which is now my second favorite microphone of all time. It's a phenomenal microphone, but the NTG is better. I love it. Next up is the camera. Now, I do happen to have a second one, even though we're filming on the camera, which is the Canon EOS R. I have a second one over here. So Canon EOS R, you guys have seen it. Every single YouTuber on the platform, it feels like over the last 3 months, has picked up a Canon EOS R. It really does have pretty much everything you need for YouTube. It has high bit rates, it has good image stabilization, even though it's not IBIS. If you have a lens that's stabilized and you use the EIS that comes inside the camera, the digital image stabilization, it has really good image stabilization, like no complaints whatsoever. One thing I love about the DJI Osmo Action that I loved from the jump, from the second I used it, was how quick it was to be able to switch from, let's say, you know, 4K 24 to 4K 60 or 1080p 120 or 240, whatever it is. It's just a click of a button, and you have the same thing with the Canon EOS R. This little mode dial, boom, you hit it, and then you could set 3 custom profiles that comes along with everything else on the screen, like aperture priority, full manual, whatever else. All your settings come up here. So I hit the mode, boom, hit C1, and I'm in 24 frames per second. Hit the mode, boom, in C2, and I'm in 60 frames per second for my slow-mo and B-roll shots. I loved the A7 III. Like, went to bat for it. If you look at some of my old videos, I'm like, this is the greatest camera on the planet right now, especially at this price point. And now the deals on the EOS R are so damn good. And I honestly like this better than the A7 III. I apologize to any Sony people out there that might have started following me because they were a Sony shooter. It doesn't mean I'm totally giving up on Sony. Who knows what the A7S III will hold. Over the last year, I've had cameras from Olympus, Sony, Canon, DJI, GoPro. Still to this day, I can't wait to shoot with this camera every day. Like, if I have something to do, I'm like, damn, I wish I could just go vlog with this camera because it's freaking great, man. So now let's move on to the lens, and we happen to be shooting with it right now. It is the RF 15-35 f2.8, and might be the best lens I've ever used in my life. Very expensive. With tax here in the US, you're gonna be paying about $2,500 for it. I think it's like $2,300 or whatever, but you know, the taxes are crazy here in the States. But let me tell you something, it's f2.8 all the way through. So from 15 all the way to 35, you're at f2.8 the whole way through. So basically what that means is, because most lenses, when you're at 15, you're gonna be at f2.8, but as you zoom in, you're gonna see aperture slowly starting to rise until you get to your furthest focal length. Kinda sucks, whereas this, you're getting f2.8 from 15 all the way to 35, and it doesn't change. So I have a 24mm f2.8, I have a 28mm f2.8, I got a 20mm f2.8, I got it all in one lens, which is the exact reason why I think that it's worth it, plus the image stabilization. I think it's worth the price point just because this is one of those lenses that just stays with you for maybe ever, for life. I'm not saying you should go out and take an extra mortgage out on your house or max your credit cards out to get this lens, but if you have the means and the patience, put a few dollars aside every now and then and just put it somewhere where you're not gonna dip into it. If you really want this lens, it's worth the money, man. It completely is worth the money. So that's it, the perfect vlogging setup. Another episode of it, and we're gonna probably keep these going. And again, it's not saying that this is the perfect vlogging setup. I'm just saying that I'm putting together an entire setup that I enjoy vlogging with, and it might be the perfect setup for you. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. I'm approaching year 2 on this platform, and I couldn't be happier, man. It's the end of 2019, we're approaching 2020. I'm gonna try my hardest to go as hard as I possibly can for 2020. I'd like to pump out 1 or 2 more videos a week with you guys. I hope everybody's spending time with their loved ones. If you're stressed out about something, if you're feeling down about something, just pick yourself back up, man. As far as we know, we only get one life in this world. We're not sure about reincarnation. We're not sure about any type of afterlife. Only thing we're sure about is when we open our eyes, we're alive for the day. And if you have any weight on your shoulders, you have any pressure on your chest, you feel like things are just crashing down on you, don't worry about it, man. It all ends the same way. None of us make it out alive, so make the best of it. Happy holidays, happy new year, merry Christmas, happy Kwanzaa, and everything else that you could celebrate. Happy day off from work. Enjoy your day, enjoy your night, and enjoy tomorrow morning. Salute!
Resume is a heavyweight, yeah. Put it on my back, give me everything, yeah. I need everything, I need all of everything.